one of the biggest changes to Apple's App Store ever. Apple says it is cutting App Store fees for the vast majority of developers from 30% to 15%. Our tech editor, Dan Howley, is here now. So, Dan, I got excited when I initially saw this, but when you dig in, you realize they're saying this reduced commission only applies to developers who pull in less than $1 million a year. So I guess the question is, does this thing go far enough?
Yeah, I think this is basically part of Apple's plan to kind of get out of or out from under the thumb of kind of the antitrust investigations that are going on surrounding it. Unlike Amazon, which, you know, I mean, it's a major part of their business, the basics program that is under scrutiny for antitrust issues, or Google, which, I mean, their entire business is under scrutiny, and Facebook with their Instagram and WhatsApp purchases. Apple's issues with antitrust are relatively small, and they relate to the App Store and how much they charge the developers that put apps in the App Store, and the fact that Apple offers its own competing apps and doesn't have to pay in-store commission. So what's going on here is it looks like Apple is trying to kind of split in the middle ground and say, we'll reduce the commission fees for some developers, those that you said make less than $1 million a year in App Store sales. That's a calendar year. And then the others will continue to pay that same fee structure. Now, what fees stand at now is 30% for every purchase made of an app goes directly to Apple, and then developers keep the 70%. And then if it's a yearly subscription, it's 15% after that first year goes to Apple for each subsequent year, and then the developer gets to keep the rest of that. But so what they're doing here is essentially cutting the main commission in half to 15%, so that they say smaller startup developers can get greater access to the capital that they raise through sales of their apps in the App Store. And, you know, this may be something that placates lawmakers. Part of the issue is that Apple does offer competing services that, you know, could shut down smaller developers. But, you know, the biggest kind of folks that want to take action against Apple for this are huge companies like Spotify, right? They are one of the biggest companies fighting Apple for the amount that it charges, as well as Epic Games. We've talked about part of the issue there has to do with Apple not allowing those companies to offer a secondary payment option. So, for instance, Spotify or Epic Games would want to put in an option for users to pay them directly rather than having to go through Apple's payment system. So it really is kind of a way for them to do a little bit without doing too much that would hurt them while still looking like they're doing a lot. And I think that's basically what Apple's plan is here, to kind of assuage the concerns of lawmakers to a degree, but not hurting them. And we had Gene Munster at Loop Ventures saying that he reduced the estimated revenue from the App Store based on this from $15.8 billion to $14.2 billion. So it's a $1.6 billion reduction for Apple, which is
that's like a spit in the bucket for Apple. I know. Yeah. All right. You summed it up nicely. Dan Howley, thank you.